In this video, I want to show you an amazing way that you can use the trim function and the substitute function to take care of those nasty, pesky spaces that just will not disappear when you use the trim function alone. Let's get going. Now, as you can see here, I have a trim function and it's just not cleaning up Sarah Brooks' name. So Sarah's got a few leading spaces in front of her name. Robert's got an additional space between his first and last name. And I'll just come down here. You'll see this AB1234. Oh, those yucky rogue spaces at the end of data as well. They cause all kinds of problems. And then down here, again, a few leading spaces that we need to get rid of. So I've run the trim function, and as you can see, it hasn't worked for any of those cells. And I'll talk a little bit more about that in a minute, but I want to show you this new feature in Copilot. Well, it was new at the time of recording. As you're watching this, it may not be so new now. But I'm going to come up here to the Data tab and make my way over to Clean Data over here. Now, one thing you do need to make sure of is when you're using Copilot, do make sure that you have your autosave turned on, okay? And then it'll work. So I'm just gonna come over here, clean data, and Excel will do a little check around the data, and immediately it's come up and said, you've got some non-breaking spaces inside the formula. That is why the trim function isn't working. There's spaces, regular spaces, and non-breaking spaces. The two are actually treated differently in Excel. They're different characters. So a normal space is a character 32, and a non-breaking space, sometimes known as a hard space, is a character 160. Totally different characters. The trim function only removes the normal spaces, the character 32. Now, you can get Copilot to do this for you if you like. So I'm just going to come over here, and it says, I'll just show you. This may have redundant extra spaces. Do you want to remove them? Hell yeah. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on apply. And it's done it for me, and you'll see now the trim function's working. Now that's great. The only thing I'd say about this is it doesn't actually empower you to understand what's going on. So yeah, it's a quick fix, and you could, if you wanted to, you could go out to Copilot now and say, you've just cleaned up this data, how did you do it? And it probably would give you a little bit of a prompt and explain how to do it. But if you want to put this in your Excel toolkit so that you know what's happening next time this comes up, keep watching. Right, the reason the trim function isn't working is because of the hard spaces. So as I've mentioned already, the trim function removes normal spaces, but not hard spaces. So using the substitute function, we will substitute the hard spaces with normal spaces, which means that trim will work. So watch this. I'm going to go over to C8 here, and we're going to start by writing my substitute function. So equals substitute, there it is there. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my text in A8 there, comma. Now I'm going to take the character that I don't want in there, that hard space, which is a character 160, and comma. Now this is what I want to replace it with or substitute it with, character 32, which is a normal space, which will mean that trim will work. And then I'll go ahead and change that. Now it has done it, but I need to now add the trim function to remove those extra spaces. So let's go up and wrap the trim function around our substitute function. And there you go. Amazing. So let's just copy that down, and you will see that we have exactly what we were going for. Amazing, right? Now you might not know this, you'll see in the exercise file, I will be using formula text, which allows me to then show you the formulas that are inside of the cells. So if you wanted or were wondering what was inside the exercise file, that's what I've used there so that you can see exactly what I am using. So if you haven't got the exercise file and you want to download it, look around on the screen somewhere, you will find a download link to be able to do that. If you're not in my insider group yet, get inside it and you will get this information before everybody else, and you can also get access to the exercise file. Right, let me know what you think in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, subscribe, and I look forward to helping you again soon. For videos on related topics, please visit my channel. For links to my courses or my weekly tips, check the description box below.